probabilistic risk assessments don't work for human behavior. They don't work when the workers at the plant refuse to walk around and do fire safety inspections like they did at San Manuel. They also don't work when the utility, in order to pass a probabilistic risk assessment impact statement of some sort, will balance making something more risky in one area by making it, they think, less risky in another area. For example, they didn't work for San Onofre because when the plant failed, if we had been told we were going to make a billion, we were going to save $1 billion, and that didn't happen. Instead, the plant disappeared. And how is that going to be in your statement? But more specifically, German roots, MH370, 9/11, that's four airplanes. A Warthog pilot stole a Warthog and flew it into a mountain after flying all over Utah and Nevada. In San Diego, a man stole a tank. The only reason that he was stopped from wherever he wanted to go, I mean anywhere, was he went up on top of a barrier and a very brave cop climbed on top of the tank, opened the door, tried to get him to stop, and when the guy started to move the tank again, he shot. In the 1970s, I believe it was, a hijacker hijacked an airplane and overflew Los Alamos. Now, how are you going to do a PRA or anything that's going to prevent those sorts of events? They're going to happen. Now, the dry casks with their half-inch thick stainless steel and the concrete overpacks, they're not going to withstand a full impact of a loaded jumbo jet. They're not going to withstand a 8-10 Warthog that's been stolen and firing 70 depleted uranium bullets per second at the thing and then dropping 500-pound bombs. There's just no way you can protect against these sorts of things. So I think it's high time that you admit that you, every time I've talked to the NRC about these problems, I get one answer, TSA. They're going to stop every single hijacking that's going to happen in the future. It wouldn't stop Germanwings. It wouldn't stop MH370. There was an Egyptian air pilot about 15 years ago that is believed to have crashed a fully loaded jumbo jet into the St. Lawrence Seaway. You're not going to be able to do any of these things. You're not going to be able to prevent against a single one of these. So why are we arguing about something that is so easily replaceable? San Onofre had $1 billion in funds that they could have been spending on renewable energy that they just holding back. And they could have been spending it during that year and a half when the plant had already failed before they decided that they were not going to restart it, which we all knew from within 6 weeks of when it failed because we knew it was fluid elastic instability that had broken it, and they had no way to protect against that. None of this is covered in any of these environmental impact statements. So how about you just give it up and let us go